My name is Charlotte, and I am doing a review of The Opposite of Loneliness by Marina Keegan. I actually don't have the book with me right now because I brought it home, forgetting that I had intended to do a review of it. I picked up this book on a whim in Barnes & Noble. I was walking out of the store, and I just saw it. I'm not sure why I picked it up, but I was drawn to it. The book is a book of stories and essays by this Yale student named Marina Keegan. She tragically died in a car accident 5 days after her graduation, but some of her professors and her family members and her friends gathered together all the work she'd done while she was at Yale and put it into a book, and it's divided into three parts. The first part is called The Opposite of Loneliness, which is an essay that she wrote for the Yale newspaper, but it reads more like a speech. The second part is her fiction, and the third part is her nonfiction. Overall, I love this book. But that being said, I loved it because the parts that I loved, I really, really loved. But then there were also parts that I honestly can't remember about the book. Some of the essays I think weren't very memorable. Couldn't really connect to them. There was one about whales that I remember sitting on my bed and reading and realizing about 5 pages, and I had no idea what she was talking about. The stories that I read that I loved so much that it kind of canceled out some of the parts that I read that I didn't like. One of my favorite stories was about a girl who comes home from college, and she starts dating this guy from her hometown, and he's really into drugs, and he introduces her to drugs, and at the same time her parents are kind of going through a separation. Her dad is an alcoholic and her mom's depressed. And her mom kind of warns her about this guy, and I don't know. It was just something about her writing in it, and the way that she can make something that seems so normal and kind of almost boring exciting, I thought was amazing. One of the other things that I really loved about this book was she wasn't trying to be or write like someone that she's not. She's 24 years old, I think, or 23, or early 20s. She just graduated college, and most of what she written was while she was at college, and she writes like she's a college student. She doesn't write like she's trying to be like a 40-year-old professor. Her writing it's young, it's really raw, it's from the 21st century. I really enjoyed it. I could really connect to it, and I think that's what some of the reviews I read about the book, I think that's what some people had problems with, is they felt like they couldn't really connect to it and she sounded like a child. But I thought that really made her writing stand out, because sometimes you'll read a book and you can just tell that the author is trying to write like somebody else, not themselves. And I just found her writing to be incredibly honest. So I would really recommend this book to anyone that just kind of wants to read about being young and what that feels like and how you deal with different things when you're young and how you see the world. Like I said, I loved the fiction section. I thought it was amazing. Her stories were original and they were funny, and I could connect to them. The nonfiction section I had a little more trouble with, but there were still some essays that I really liked, like her Opposite of Loneliness essay, which I think got over 1 million hits at Yale, was basically just about being young and having a lot of opportunity and your life isn't ending, even though it feels like it's ending. And it was really short, but she's just a really honest writer, which I thought was really refreshing. If you have any questions or comments, leave them below. And I'm not sure what kind of video we'll be doing next. Margo might be doing a review, or I might be doing a review, or we might be doing a book tag. I'm not sure. But either way, we'll see you soon. Bye.